Good afternoon. I'd like to call the Personnel Committee to order for the meeting for June 2nd. I'm Steve Havey, and I am the chair of this committee. First of all, we'd like to have a roll call of the members.
Mr. Havey?
Here.
Mr. Harris?
Here.
Mrs. Burdick? Mr. Graves?
Here.
Mr. Rickey?
Here.
Mrs. Rue?
Here.
Mr. Stockin?
Here.
Mr. Crandall?
Here.
7 members present and 1 absent.
Thank you. First up, we have the approval of minutes from May 5. Mr. Graves and Mr. Harris. Any comments or suggestions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That is carried. We also have minutes from May 19. That would be Mrs. Root and Ms. Harris. Any corrections, comments on that one? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? And that is carried. Thank you very much. Next up, we have our personnel officer, Mr. Budinger. Are you available to speak?
I am available.
Outstanding. I like your cane. That's much better than
Thank you.
Other stuff you had.
So each year our employees receive their new steps for the year on January 1st. Some of our employees that do not receive their increments on that date are our new employees that are hired between July 1st and December 31st of 2020. They have to wait the 6 months before they get their first step. So I'm here to request permission to move forward with those increments on July 1st. This is an annual request. We do this every year.
So moved.
Excellent. Mr. Graves and seconded by Mr. Stockin. Questions and comments? Mr. Barnes.
Can you explain increments? In other words, if a person's hired 6 months ago, they're last year, is that increment at the percent rate that all employees got at the beginning of the year?
So we have steps, increment steps, same thing. And there's different amounts for different unions. For our non-unit people, we have 11. For AFSCME, we have 7. NYSNA has 6, and PEP has 11. So there's different steps. So each year, employees, they'll move up a step each year, and it's always on January 1st. This is in addition to any raise that we would give them. So if we gave them no raise, they would still get their step. Right, until they're at the end of their steps. Once they're at the end of their steps, then the only raise that they would get is any annual raise that you provide them. The basis for that is, at least my understanding of it is, each year these employees, when they come in, they gain experience, so we're rewarding them for that additional knowledge and ability going forward. So the only time that we don't give it on January 1st, like I stated, are our brand new employees who are hired right at the end of the year, the thought being that you're not going to just hire them and then just give them that increment right off the bat because they haven't been here for very long. So we right. So we delay that to July 1st. Now after that, they're back on cycle with everyone else, and it goes on January 1st.
How long does the increment continue? In other words, if a person's in the same job,
they'll get it every year until they hit the end of how many steps there are.
That's what my question is. How many steps are there?
Well, it depends. Again, if you're a nurse in NYSNA, there's 6 steps. If you're AFSCME, there's 7. Non-unit, there's 11. And PEP, there's 11.
And those are all due to their contract for
their
that
contracts, job. Correct. Yep.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Any other questions for Mr. Budinger? All right. Hearing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That is carried.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bob. Okay, next up we have Workman's Compensation Executive Secretary Heather Beddow. Hi.
Hi, good afternoon. I am requesting approval of the 2022 workers' comp budget. I think everyone has in their packet.
We have a move from Mr. Graves and a second from Mr. Harris. Questions? If you have the document in front of you, you might have questions. No? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That's carried. You have one more thing for us, I think.
I do. I am also requesting approval of the 2022 apportionments to the members.
Moved by Mr. Harris, second by Mr. Stockton. Questions or comments? All those? Sure.
I'd just like to note that there's not a single municipality in District 5 that had a reduction this year.
Very useful information.
We're paying our fair share.
Very useful information. Thank you, sir. Anything else? Oh, Mr. Graves. Mr. Barnes. Pardon me, Mr. Graves.
Yeah, I was just looking at this and a little confused on your assessments. You show a total for the towns of $344,000 and villages $122,000. Then you have a total of $948,000. Where's the difference?
The counties at the top, Allegheny County.
Oh, okay. I missed that. I was looking all over and there it was. Okay.
And then
Thank you much.
You're welcome. Then there's $2,000 from employment and training for the summer youth employment program to total the $950,000.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Other questions? None? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That's carried. Thank you, Heather.
Thank you.
Okay, we do have a couple of items, referrals from committees. The Office for the Aging Director, Anita Madison, is requesting permission to create 3 part-time permanent laborer positions. These positions will provide housekeeping chore activities in the homes of seniors to reduce the number of clients on the waiting list for home care services. Annual salary is $19,131 with benefits of $1786.83. And moved by Mr. Stockton, second by Mr. Rickey. Any comments or questions? I'm not prepared to answer this question, but you go ahead if you want.
I just wonder if it's in the budget.
Let's see if I have any information on that. Who would know? Do we know if it's in the budget? That's a very tough question, sir.
I'm not sure if it is in the budget. To be honest with you, I think Terry over here is looking it up or trying to look it up. Anita did receive extra money that she was not anticipating, so I'm not sure if this was in the budget or covered by additional grants received after the budget was finalized.
Let's say there's a 10%, county funding involved. I'm just curious if it's curious if it's in the budget or we got to do a transfer.
Yes, but I could be wrong. Anita's not here to help, but I don't believe this was money that she had anticipated when we did the 2021 budget last year.
And if I can just, I have not had any conversations with Anita about the budgeting on these positions, so I am unable to answer that question at this point in time.
Would it be advisable to table this until we know the exact numbers?
I don't think it hurts.
Well, that's so moved. Up to the committee. So moved to table. A second?
A second.
Okay. Mrs. Root? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Okay. With one dissent, that is tabled. Second, we have a request from the Ways and Means Committee. County Attorney Jeff Donegan is requesting permission to create 1 full-time office aide position to be filled for a 6-month period. Salary is $10,005 and between $10,005 and $12,600 with benefits between $2,422 and $2,906, and this is 100% funded by county funds. Move it for discussion. Mr. Harris, second. Mr. Stockton. Okay. Now.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Harris.
I read Mr. Donegan's explanation here, but I was wondering if you could just speak to it a little bit, please.
So as far as what we're asking for, we've had to move offices recently. We have lots of files and paper files from the old location that will need to be scanned in, organized. So a lot of this for a 6-month period is to get us established in our new location, to get the files, the paper files under control, compliant with our confidentiality obligations. obligations are obligations for how long we need to retain certain documents and making sure we have all that in order. So this help would be scanning and filing and helping to organize a lot of those documents. And the current staff I have does not have the time to help with that process.
Any place you could borrow somebody like this, Chris?
Possibly. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I don't think that has been discussed.
It appears this is not in the budget.
I'd also, you know, when this office was taken over, it had been understaffed for a considerable amount of time, and the piles that have been piling up are getting quite large. It would be helpful to get this moving sooner rather than later to address these issues.
Mr. Stock.
He also noted in relation to budget that they've had several positions not filled, and so there's plenty of other funds from that to fund this. I'm in favor of it.
So it is in the budget? It's been ciphered in?
It's my understanding it's not in the budget. However, there is surplus funds.
There's been approval to have three assistant attorneys previously approved, and there is not currently three assistant attorneys. So the funds from that would be available to those should the office have been filled that entire time is what that surplus funds are from at this point. And again, this is just for a 6-month period that we're asking while we get this organized.
Jeff, I just want to know that we're going to go forward, not backwards, money-wise.
The funding.
If you got it covered, you got it covered.
The funding is kind of irrelevant for the county attorney's point ones, which is their personnel, because there were a number of positions, like Jeff's just said, that were fully funded that we did not fill. However, each of those positions generates revenue, so the revenue will not be up to expectations either for this budget. So when you look at both the point ones for personnel and the revenues for the 2021 budget, he will not meet projections on either side.
Good.
So it's good.
It's kind of a wash at this point.
All right.
Okay. Other questions and comments? All right. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? And that is carried. Thank you. Will there be any old business, you guys? New business. Good of the order.
Mr. Chairman, as it appears there's no further business to conduct, I move we adjourn.
Mr. Graves moves that we adjourn. Do we have a second? Mr. Rickey. All those in favor say aye. Opposed? Thank you. We stand adjourned. Good meeting.